Hello everyone, my name is Aryeom. I am a director of ZeMarmot.
And my name is Jehan, and I do mostly technical stuff. So, okay. So, like, we will try to answer this question today. What is ZeMarmot? So people like exactly understand the project. Yeah. And okay, so we will. Want to explain? No. Okay. So we presented this project. We like announced it a year ago at LibGraphics meeting in where was it? In Toronto. And it was in May, I think. So we will show you the. Okay, but this needs to be. Yeah, now if you don't...
I can set it up in like 2 minutes.
Oh, 2 minutes?
I just need to bring over the hardware from the other room.
Okay.
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 Let's wait two minutes together.
So, ZeMarmot, it's...
Yeah, ZeMarmot is an animated feature film. Yeah, we will show you a teaser movie
In 2 minutes.
Yeah, in 2 minutes.
Actually, you can watch. It's just 1 minute of movie. We could watch without sound, and it's that's what we used to basically advertise the project a year ago when we presented it, and when we presented it actually the same day as we made the talk at LibGraphics meeting, we also started a crowdfunding. So that this video that you are going to see.
Here he is.
Okay, let's see. Okay.
This was a teaser movie. I made this a long time ago, so it's a little bit different.
Comment, it's entirely drawn with GIMP.
I draw with GIMP and I editing with Blender.
So some people sometimes ask us if it's drawn on paper and if it has been scanned or whatever. It's not, it's entirely digital.
We will quickly do a 1 year report. Okay, next. This one was a concept art. It's actually a concept sketch. This project started from comics. I sketched some things to make comics first, but we changed the mind, so we make animation right now. And this is character design. Actually, before I make this character design, I never seen a real mammoth. So I searched it on the internet, but anyway, I made some of these characters. And yeah, this one was you saw in the teaser movie. I hope you recognize it. And yeah, when I made this one, it looks like a mammoth. Yeah, cool. I like it. I was proud of it. And people liked it also. And they replied it on it. Oh, what a pretty cat. So yeah, after we did research, I met a real mammoth in the Alps, and I studied with clay, and I made another character design, and I think it looks more like mammoth, I hope so. Yeah, and these are side characters. Yeah.
So also okay. So some other things that we did since in this year is like I finished the script for the also the what we hope to do is like feature length movie if we could, and but since we don't have money, we like broke down, and it's basically now what we are doing is what I call the pilot, but it's not a series. The goal is, so it will be basically the start of the movie. And just quickly, the story of the movie is basically a mammoth from the Alps which decide to travel the world. So so traveling mammoth.
And these are storyboard. First time I draw on the papers is a traditional way, but I just drew on the GIMP. It was an easier way. And so, and animatics is, storyboard is a kind of guide to make real animation. I wrote down a detailed, here is some action, here is some sound, like this. Animatic is I put on the video that images, and you can see the sample.
So this is just, we have the full animatics actually. If you want to see it, we can show you for the full pilot, but we don't show it publicly. We can show it after if you want. So this is just an excerpt of 30 seconds because we don't want to spoil like the story. So that's why publicly we only or ever show a small, just, so what's an animatic? So. Aryeom gets out of the hole, the burrow, and it's hungry. It looks for food. We can see very well, so I explain. And it sees
found a nice flower. Yeah, flower. And it is not really exact timing, which is what I want, but I can see, I can help, I can get help with this. Yeah.
Yeah.
And production, we are in progress, in production. And usually I draw frame by frame. So we make a 24 frame second movie, and I draw usually 12 frame per second, and sometimes I draw 8, and sometimes 24. I mean, it really depends on acting. And this one is only has a keyframe. So I will show you again.
You can see it's kind of lagging when we drawn is a keyframe.
Yeah, a little bit tuck, 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 like this. And I made in between.
Okay, just.
And it failed actually, because the face too much, how to say, giggling. I I shouldn't touch my keyframes, but when I draw, it's a little bit weird. So I touch a little bit and touch a little bit, and it broke up. So I draw all again. Oh, sorry. It looks better. I hope you can catch that. Yeah, different thing. I like that way I make animation. So, and if I color, it is different cut, but. Oh yeah, it's too short, so I show you again and again.
So we show this also because a lot of people are asking, well, what's animation exactly? Well, what do you do? And so that's why. Sorry. Okay.
No.
Music. Oh. Okay. So another part of the animation is music. So the music you heard was in the teaser was music. It's we work with a group of musicians who are doing a lib art also and only use free software. They're not in the same city as us, so it's not always easy because we discuss through internet and we have been exchanging lately emails and they send us small ideas of for various scenes. And so like here for instance I was just like basically that's our animatic and I was just like making comments. So I comment every detail of the animatic what we want and then after they propose something and so yeah, music is also like part which is not easy remotely, but yeah. And yeah, you can see I use Ardour. It's a really great software for all the everything sound related. So at ZeMarmot, it's also software development because so there's animation part, which is most public facing, and the software development, which is mostly me. And like for storyboarding, like basically, as you saw, storyboarding is mostly like breaking scenes into cuts. Not into cuts, into like keyframes actually, into keyframes, and then you comment area. So if you remember, that's what a traditional storyboard page look like. You can just search this on internet, you search storyboard, and that's what it looks like. It's like you have one image, it's mostly keyframes basically. I mean, that's the most detailed storyboard that you get will be keyframes. So and it can be less detailed with comments, what's happening, if you have a panning, if you have a zoom, and I mean, I don't know if here we can see there sometimes, you know, she makes arrows here, like something. So I've been trying to, it's done as a GIMP plugin. I've been trying to like reproduce this with like automatic preview, which so basically that's, we building the animatic live from, because the animatic is mostly the storyboard taken and just one image after at a time, and then we try to have an idea of what the movie will look like. Then we can try to get the timing and then we can know how long will the movie last. So from our animatic, our pilot will be about 8 minutes. So that's it. And so like then after this, the animation part, it's also as a plugin to GIMP. That's a first version which was more like, you know, time frame style. And I like right now I'm trying another version which is basically the same as a time frame, but it's like this. It's inspired from what we call X sheet, exposition sheet. If same, you can search on internet an X sheet and you get the traditional. You see it from, you know, all the animation, you know, all Disney or Ghibli or whatever, and you will have scan of them. So, which basically, you know, you get layers, animation layers, the background, the mammoth, the trees, like this. So that's something, that's what I'm working on right now, is that's to improve the process. And also I work on GIMP itself a lot. So like in the last 2 years, we released, you know, a development version 2.9.2, 2.9.4. And actually, in GIMP, in core GIMP, I have like, I counted yesterday night, I have like 300, nearly 400 commits. And just in the last year, since we announced the ZeMarmot, I have 254. So like basically most of my involvement of GIMP is like kind of really tied to the ZeMarmot. So that's and it's all for the ZeMarmot because it's like improving GIMP and making it stable so that there's no crash and all the little annoyance, adding features also, but that's not my not necessary the most important actually sometimes. Also I'm trying to think a lot about, you know, the UI of GIMP. Things could be improved. So like, actually, I created a new mailing list, official mailing list, GIMP key, to discuss all the user experience in GIMP and like all to improve the UI. And I don't think any of the Gnome designers are there. I was trying yesterday night to like ask them to get involved in GIMP again because they used to be, but right now we don't have any designers. So like that's something also I'm trying to revive. It's like a long, I mean it's not for like tomorrow, but I think it could happen slowly, hopefully, because I think GIMP really deserves to have a second life, a second, you know. So yes, so that's work on GIMP. And so on software side is also like, since we're in the GNOME conference, GUADEC, you know, like the question is that is GNOME ready? So for me, it's like desktop ready. So the famous joke is desktop on Linux ready, and I think it is. You can do everything that anyone on any other operating system can do. So for media, for creative arts, you know, it works. We do it. I won't pretend that it's easy every day. So. So graphic tablets, it mostly works. It works. But we have sometimes issues and you know, buttons which stop working, and then we have to make bug reports, and then it doesn't happen before 6 months, 1 year, or if ever. Screens. I think like I spoke also with some of the designers. I think most GNOME is never fully thought with dual screen. It's like probably I think most people, the designers, they think after this, oh, how will it work when there's a dual screen? I think this can be improved a little. We have a bunch of bug reports on Bugzilla with using dual screen and screen auto rotation. We don't really care, but I just tried once and I saw it didn't work. I mean, and so there are a lot of So color management, it's like big question also when you do, graphics art. And I have the, you know, color hug, where you all know, like Risha hugs, and with it's cool open hardware colorimeter and stuff, but it's not as good right now, but as what they have in proprietary hardware. But yeah, I'm using this, which also I think Richard Hugs is also the one who makes the software behind GNOME color management. We sometimes, I had crash actually when using sometimes proprietary color emitter. So the assets is a big question. It's something I'm really interested in because we have a lot of files. I can guess, you know, when you do a project like this and I'm looking like to the right way, and I still haven't found it, you know, to manage all these files. You know, like when you manage a project, like if it's code or if it's vectorial stuff, it's very easy. You know, I go Git, you know, everybody goes Git. You know, Git, I tried, it just multiplies the size, you know, like there's no like diff with binary files, basically, or if there is anything, it's not optimized. So that's So what all the other way to not only make backups, we make backups, like all style backups, but you know, manage a lot of data and like version data and in easy way also, because it's also the problem when you use Git or subversion, because subversion is sometimes more adapted to binary files for some reasons, and not for size reason, but actually it can also be, because you can also make shorter history, which with Git you can, but then you cannot push anymore, so that's make it useless for Git. So yes, that's a lot of question, and I'm still looking for the answers. And also for references, we have a lot of, when we went to the Alps, I don't know, we have like 100 gigas of photos and videos. And we actually went twice to the Alps. We went again a few months ago. We met people, we researched Marmot from University of Lyon 1 in France. So that's, we have a lot of these, and I would love to have something not like to manage, you know, our references and this. Yeah, I'm sharing everything. We use OnCloud for all sharing stuff. And so, what about the software? Free software, not only GNOME. So GIMP, I think it's cool. It can be better, but it's very cool and it's very stable now. And don't use a stable version. Actually, use a dev version. We use only the development version for last year. It's stable. It's so much better than the 2.8. And okay, the Inkscape scripts for, you know, vectorial and publishing, and they're good software. And but the real like missing link, I think that's something I've been seeing here a lot. And I know it's sad because there's a PTV guy around. He's not here, and but we don't have a good video editor in free software right now. You know, like that doesn't exist. So we use Blender, not because it's as a video editor, at least not for the 3D part. Not because Blender is very awesome as a video editor, just because it's the best, but it's still very bad user experience. I mean, probably only people like crazy like us will just try to do a movie actually with fully with Blender. I mean, a 2D movie. 3D movie is very good software. I mean, maybe I spoke about this. So yeah, I think the stuff what if we want for media works, we need a real video editor for 2D which works, which doesn't crash, because that's the main problem with all the other non-Gnome and Blender. They have like their features issue. Blender can do everything. That's a very good stuff. The others, they have a lot of missing features, and also they are not stable. They just crash for no reason, you know. PTV, OpenShot, Skadian Live, and yes. So that's our area of interest, obviously. You know, painting, animating, video editing, resource management. You have also Exchange. That's something also which we miss, like software that don't talk with each other. And you know, like we all know that in proprietary software, like, they have suites of software, you know, and you can exchange files very easily and stuff. So when you work on a project on like multimedia, like with painting and then video editing, you can really right now we like have to export our layers to import them into Blender manually, which could be Blender or PTV or whatever, but you have to export them manually, set them manually. It's like very boring, you know, it's not optimal at all. So yeah, that's kind of stuff I would love to work on, and I'm working on some of them, but I don't have time to work on them. And or if we had money, I would even hire people, you know, to work on some piece, on some part of this, to improve things. So yes. So what else is ZeMarmot? It's also libart. So the licenses of the movie. As we like, you know, copyleft and everything, and so not only do free software, but the movie itself is Creative Commons paternity share like by SA, which is basically same as GPL but for creative for artistic works, and it's double licensed with Alib free art. Basically the same, and they're even compatible, so it's nearly useless to actually to tell both of them, but you know, we kind of like this one also. Anyway, so we like to share. So actually, when we finish, the goal also is like the final artwork, which will be the movie, but also we want to like to free all the assets, basically all our XCF files with all the layers and whatever. If people wants to remix them, do something with some images, they will be welcome to do so. It will be also available under the same license and share some knowledge, also explain, try to explain. We don't do it enough, we don't have time, but I'm trying to explain a little on our blog the process of what's animation making and everything. And when I have time, I make some posts on various topics like this. And yes. And so finally, what ZeMarmot also like trying to make us some kind of studio, which is like little funny because right now, let's be honest, it's just mostly the two of us and the musicians, of course. So yes. So we have a non-profit association with us that I co-founded like 10 years ago or something like that. But which is called Lila, like libre comme l'art in French, is like free as art. We had also this name Studio Girin, which actually is more of an informal name because there's no entity, really official entity like Lila. And so it's us, Aryeom, Jehan, AMMD, and then that's something we would love to do if we had the money. That's to make an actual studio and like to like a free art studio, making maybe hopefully a lot of free movies and like improving whatever the stack of software, of media software. So yes. I'm not sure if it's also compatible with the cinema industry, of course. When you do a long feature-length movie, you always hope like if that we will send it to festival and stuff like this, but will it stop here? Can it go to cinema? You know, I don't know. Actually, we had a production which approached us for a movie after the crowdfunding, two times, the same production. But we didn't want to actually, because, you know, we were doing free art and we know that that's not possible. I mean, it could be possible actually if we had a lot of funding. Maybe if we had a lot of funding and like 1,000 people supporting us every month or something like that, then maybe we could discuss with productions and keep all the free art aspects and everything. But right now, if we accept a deal, it becomes a movie like any other. So we made a stupid choice, not the money one, but we hope it will go better actually. So yeah, that's a question, and I hope we can answer with a yes someday. So that's why also we are looking. We have been doing a lot of funding files and stuff, and I've tried even like send emails, but I don't know to who, to like Susie or Red Hat or everything, you know, if they were interested into funding our project. But you know, that's the kind of stuff I never even got answer on this. So and then I try also funding on more common, you know, like creative funding things. But until now we haven't had any real big funding like this. We just have our crowdfunding. So we made the original crowdfunding on Indiegogo, so a year ago. And now we subscribe on these two platforms. One is in US dollar, one is euro, which are like, you know, monthly subscription platforms. I don't know if you know, Patreon is the most known of them. It's like basically it's free price. Basically people can make, some people make just $1 or €1 a month. Some people, I think the one who give most is like someone gives us $15 a month or something like that. So it's subscribe and you can unsubscribe whenever you want. If we do shit at some point, people can unsubscribe, you know. I think right now we have about 120 euro a month or something like that. So both combined together. So yes, and So yeah, that's our conclusion. So the question, what is the ZeMarmot's answer is like, so the animated feature film, which is also free art, lib art, made Creative Commons by SA. It's also some project of some film made with free software. And that we hope could get bigger, could maybe someday become a studio until we run out of money, before we run out of money, rather. So yeah, that's it.
Thank you very much.
And so if you have any questions, you can ask us.
So I've seen the blog posts and actually wondered what the hell are you talking about. Now I've seen your talk and it's amazing. Thanks. Question I have is there was a I don't remember the name. There was some 2D animation studio software that was open sourced some years ago. Did you consider using that instead of modifying GIMP?
It's you know, not 2 years ago. It was like 6 months ago, I think. The one used by Ghibli.
No, it's really old. It was based on GTK 1.2 when it came out. It's Synfig. No.
Ah, Synfig?
Yeah, Synfig.
Ah, okay. Synfig is vectorial animation. So it's just not what we do, like, you know, what they call cell animation, because it used to be like on celluloid, so basically layers where actual transparent papers and you draw, it's bitmap, it's a raster. And vectorial animation is basically it's 3D on 2D. That's you create models like puppets, and then you move them, and you don't draw frame by frame. It's like that's we like the 2D style actually. It's if you see a vector animation, you know that's a vector animation. It's usually they're like this, you know, because it's. I mean, it's a choice. It can be a choice. It can be an artistic choice also. Like if South Park, I don't think it's vectorial, but it could be vectorial typically. And South Park, it's a choice. They don't get the. Oh, My Little Pony is vectorial. My Little Pony is vectorial. It's but we don't. And Synfig is vectorial. The Synfig Matne also has a project. I don't remember. The name. He has a project, an animation project on you can search it on internet. It's Morevna project. I think it's his studio name, Morevna Studio, and M O R E V N A. I think it's the name of the studio and not of the project. And he does. You can see what he does. So that's completely different techniques. So yeah, we cannot use this.
Okay.
We've tried to preload Libre Music, and it's hard to find stuff that's really like catchy and stuff like that. So I was wondering, do you guys use also like pre-existing sound, or is it all like specifically made for this film?
In this case, it will be all made for this. I mean, the teaser was music from these people, but pre-existing, because we made the teaser quite quick, you know, just kind of under the pressure for the crowd. We wanted to make our crowdfunding just the day of Flip Graphics meeting that they started. But for this project, I mean, I think it's I like it. I like to have like music made for this. I don't know. So you want to say something? Maybe no.
Thank you.
I think what you're doing is really important, also sharing the workflow. Now, Blender did something similar. They did multiple short films.
Yeah.
How did they manage the funding, and can't you do something similar?
I think we are doing something similar, but it's hard. I think the answer to how did they manage the funding is with time. When you check the funding of the, I cannot tell numbers, but I'm pretty sure that's true. If you check the funding of the first movie and the funding of the last movie, which was like still a failure because they didn't get the money they wanted, but they get like several hundred thousand euros still, you know, like, so for a failure, it's a failure I would like to have, you know. It's time, you know. It's basically, so that's, for me, that's the reason. You just try and try again. At some point, you get more and more people, and people follow you and like you and or your project, rather. And we could check on internet. The first project, they didn't get the money that they are getting now. You know, it's just now they are known. So, yeah, I don't think there is on the internet for funding. There is no secret recipe. It's more like trying not to abandon too early. I think that's actually main recipe. It's just trying to, you know, continue.
Then, if there are no other questions. Thank you both very much.